Welcome to a new planetary and seismic update. Before we go into the geometry that we're going to have in the next couple of days, I would like to show you what happened earlier. If you look on the SGI graph, we see strong earthquakes, almost one per day, which is well above average, not counting the aftershocks at the Southeast Loyalty Islands. This has everything to do with the geometry between Mars and Jupiter, as you can see here in the solar system, relative to Earth, which allowed the Moon to make critical geometry with both planets in a very short time. It started on the 17th when the geometry with the Moon, Mars and Jupiter came within 4 hours. It peaked on the 22nd, 23rd, and then on the 27th, roughly, it went over 4 hours again when the angle, the 90 degree angle between Mars and Jupiter widened. Okay? So that is what happened. Let's go to what is going to happen. If we look at the SGI graph for the coming week, we see very critical planetary geometry coming up. Tomorrow already with Venus, Mercury and Neptune, and that's a critical conjunction. And it will be followed a day later by Mars, Mercury and Saturn, also a critical conjunction where Mercury is between the planets Mars and Saturn, really critical. And then another day later, and that will be on the 2nd of June, Venus, Sun, Jupiter. And if you may recall, we had Sun, Venus, Jupiter on 5 February, just before the major earthquakes in Turkey. There was also a convergence of planetary conjunctions, and Sun, Venus, Jupiter was part of that. Now Venus is on the other side of the Sun, so we have Venus, Sun, Jupiter. And again, we have a convergence of planetary conjunctions. 3 in total is going to be really critical. And as you can see, we have additional critical geometry depicted here on the SGI graph. You can look at that yourself, take the time to study that because it is going to be significant. In the solar system, we see this planetary geometry depicted. And we also have Earth, Mercury and Uranus coming up on the 4th, and that will be at the time of full moon. So if we go back to the SGI graph here, we see on the 4th the full moon, and we can see that the critical planetary geometry, that's the convergence on the 31st, the 1st and 2nd of June, happens just days before the full moon. And there, right there, Earth, it will be in a conjunction with Mercury and Uranus as well. Based on this SGI graph, I would estimate that from the 2nd to the 4th of June approximately will be most critical. We could see very large seismic activity as a result, depending on the stress levels in Earth's crust. We could be talking about a megafrost earthquake in the worst case scenario. I also would like to show you the green peaks, that's with the Moon, that will be on the 1st of June with Mars, a 90 degree angle, and in about 2 days, 2.5 days, we see another 90 degree angle with the Moon and Saturn. In the coming weeks and months, that time, the time between those two lunar peaks, the dashed peaks, will be shorter until they will be virtually at the same time. And that will culminate roughly the end of July, early August, and by that time Neptune will join with similar geometry, and that will be very critical in August, around August most likely. But let's focus on what we're going to have in the coming days, because that lunar geometry of Mars and Saturn happens at the same time that we have this critical geometry, the convergence of critical planetary geometry in the coming days. We also see a high lunar peak on June 1st, and that will be a lunar conjunction with Jupiter. So as you can see, a lot's going to happen in the solar system anyway, and we could see really strong, major, possibly megafrost seismic activity in the first week of June. If I look at the atmospheric fluctuations that we had in recent days, we have actually three of them, and the first one occurred on the 24th of May, and if we count about 6 days, we would end up today, tomorrow, and in the next few days possibly could become significant, and that fluctuation was over Pakistan. Then we had fluctuations marking on the 27th the Andaman Islands region and possibly to the north into China. And the Andaman Islands region, and also to the north, there are subduction zones. The Earth is capable of producing earthquakes well over 8 magnitude in these regions. So be aware in the next several days. And then finally, on the 28th, there was a really recognizable fluctuation, strong fluctuation, marking the Cascadia subduction zone. But it could also be to the South California or to the north into Alaska. This is a rough estimate. The fluctuations are certainly not 100%. So if you are in an earthquake-prone area, be on extra alert in the coming days, because the planetary geometry and also the lunar geometry is going to be really critical. It happens just days before the full moon. So we could see a major seismic event around the time of full moon. It could be a little bit later or a little bit earlier. Again, I'd say from the 2nd to the 4th will probably be most critical, but it could start already a little bit earlier than that. Be on extra alert. Stay safe. Until next time.